especially in the state and the nation in general. That brings me to the issue of the profiling of the Fulani, which we kicked against, and we have no apology for what we have done. Because what we have done is to say the truth, that there is no crime, there is no tribe or group that is free from criminality. And we are not saying that to spite anybody or to spark unnecessary controversy. We have made the point. Nigerians across the board have discussed it. And I'm happy to say that from all indication, majority of sensible Nigerians have appreciated what we have said, and that is the point. I will therefore need not to mention anything about this matter for fear that the controversy will be escalated, and I therefore listen to voices of reason and keep quiet about it. Let me use this medium to commend the professional bodies, such as the Veterinary Medical Association, Medical and Health Workers Union of Nigeria, the Nigerian Association of Animal Scientists, in complementing the efforts of my administration in the area of animal production and health generally. I must call on our brothers, the Fulani, to make sure that they make their activities free of criminality. They must make sure that they fish out the bad acts among them, because criminality is criminality. And in as much as we try to protect them and show Nigerians that they cannot be profiled badly, they should also make efforts to show that, yes, majority of them are good citizens and they are contributing positively to the growth and development of Nigeria, because our protein needs in the country would not have been met without the sacrifices that they are making. I want to also acknowledge that they are making so much sacrifice. In their own nomadic and pastoral life, we hardly provide schools, health facilities, roads. Even their right of way have been impinged. And that is why we set up a committee in Bauchi State that one of the leaders of Fulani made allusion to. And very soon we are going to implement the recommendation of that committee in a manner that we will free the resources that belongs to the pastoralists. They must have their own right of way so that we will reduce the conflicts between the Fulanis and the farmers, because they are the ones that provide for our sustenance on a daily basis. And I must call on our traditional institutions, our local authorities, the forest officers, to make sure that they heed the warning that we have given earlier, so that they can stop the encroachment that they are doing that is causing a lot of conflict. I remain loyal to my Kawanai Fulani, and to tell you that what I will do, I will not say it here, but I will do everything to make sure that I protect you and lend support to you, because I know you mean well, because through time and history, you have been seen to be cajoled, lampooned, and subjected to caricature, but you remain human, you remain simple, you don't show so much aggression, and of course, that humility is always what we recognize, and this is what a character that you always try to show. Please don't carry the AK-47 that I made a figurative allusion. Try to make sure that you remain peaceful. Thank you very much.